नमस्कार लिसनर्स, आई एम पलक गुप्ता, प्रेजेंट विद द कंटेंट ऑफ प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ आरटीएस चैनल मिस्टर गिरीश बिल्लौरे। यू मस्ट नो दैट इंडिया इज अ कंट्री ऑफ फेस्टिवल्स। कल्चरल एथनिक ट्रेडिशंस आर बोर्न इन द विलेजेस ऑफ इंडिया। एवरी फेस्टिवल इज सेलिब्रेटेड कीपिंग नेचर इन माइंड। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट The Festival of Rain. Today's podcast technical assistant and editor is Engineer Siddharth Gautam. Let us discuss about the socio-cultural festivals celebrated during rainy season in India. In ancient India, socio-economic and cultural activities were carried out in rural areas. The life of the people of India based on the principle of simple living and high thinking. Unity and mutual cooperation were important among the rural people. Due to this tendency of rural India, cultural continuity has remained uninterrupted. This is the reason that our civilization is intact. Among all the other civilizations of the world, only Indian civilization exists in an advanced form. Cultural activities, especially during Sawan and Bhadrapad, used to be conducted in contemporary rural India, which can now be called the basis of cultural continuity. In fact, in India, provisions have been made for some cultural events in every month of Indian traditional calendar. Here, we are discussing the events occurring on the dates mentioned in Sawan and Bhadrapad calendar of Hindu traditional calendar. According to traditions, Nag Panchami is first festival dedicated to ecosystem. This festival celebrated on the fifth day of the month of Sawan. This festival is celebrated in Madhya Pradesh as well as Uttar Pradesh and the other Hindu speaking areas. On Nag Panchami, we Hindu worship snakes, which includes that it is necessary for every living creature to be present on earth to regulate the ecosystem. Some people believe that the celebration of Nag Panchami in India was started by the king of the Naga dynasty. But we believe that snakes have a special role in protecting the grains grown in agricultural India from rats, insects, etc. Snakes are an essential creature for the ecosystem in nature. This festival is an opportunity to express gratitude to this important creature of nature. Snakes are worshipped by painting murals of them on the walls of the house. Coal paste and glue, that is natural gum, are used for making these wall paintings. After Nag Panchami, Amavasya occurs on the 15th day of Sawan month. This festival is celebrated as Jiroti festival in Malwa, Nimad, Bhuvna regions of Madhya Pradesh. For Jiroti worship, wall paintings are made on the right and left side of the entrance of the middle room of the house. Ochre, chui mitti, gum and natural colors are used in these wall paintings. Events like wrestling are organized by men on Nag Panchami. The month of Sawan ends with an emotional festival which is called Rakhi or Raksha Bandhan. This festival is dedicated to brother-sister relationship. On this festival, a silk thread is tied on the brother's wrist. According to Indian mythology, apart from the battle between King Bali and the gods and demons, there are descriptions of Raksha Bandhan during the Mahabharata period. According to the incident in the Mahabharata, the credit for making Raksha Bandhan a festival centered on brother-sister relationships, socially important, goes to Lord Krishna. It was only after this that Raksha Bandhan became a symbol of the sacred relationship between brother and sister. According to the story, when Krishna killed Shishupal with his Sudarshan Chakra, his finger got injured. Then Draupadi tied a piece of her silk sari on his finger. Krishna also promised to protect Draupadi throughout his life. Katli festival comes on the next day of Raksha Bandhan. On this day, according to age and hierarchy, younger people visit older people. In this mutual meeting, kajlis are exchanged. Kajaliyas are grown wheat plants that are 8 to 10 days old. Kajli is taken to each other's house, and by exchanging it, gratitude and respect is expressed towards each other. This is a social ritual. Through this ritual, one farmer gives information to another farmer about the fertility of owner's land. One farmer receives detailed information about the fertility of the land from other farmer. Information is also exchanged. The festival of Halchhat is celebrated on 6th day after Raksha Bandhan, that is on the 6th day of Bhadrapad. Festival of Halchhat highlight the importance of field tools used in the farming. On this festival, women worship plants like kas, palash leaf and the tools useful in agricultural work. After worshipping the plants, the women consume food made from grains including millets that are cultivated without the use of plows or the use of oxen. This festival is celebrated as birthday of Sri Krishna's elder brother called Balram or Baldau. If you know about India, then you must have definitely know about Sri Ram and Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna has a direct connection with Mahabharata and Gita. Sri Krishna was born on the 8th day of Bhadrapad. Sri Krishna's birthday is celebrated as Janmashtami festival in India. Due to ISKCON, many activities are held on Sri Krishna's birthday in all over the world. This is not only a religious ritual. This is a festival to remember Karma Yogi Lord Krishna. If you like the podcast, please subscribe to the channel. We will be waiting for your comments and pressing the bell icon.